Hi, this is Anne from Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you two ways to draw a laurel wreath in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. All right, we're here in Illustrator, and I'm just going to create a new document. We'll come up here to Print, choose Letter, and then we'll come down here to Create. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is draw a little laurel. So I'll hit L on my keyboard to get to the circle tool. I'm just going to hold Shift and draw a perfect circle. I'll zoom in with my Z tool. I'll get on my selection tool and then I'll click and drag while holding Shift and Option, or Shift and Alt on a PC. Now I've got two circles that overlap. I only really want this center piece, so I'm going to hit Shift M on my keyboard to get to my shape builder, and then I'll hold Alt or Option and click each piece that I don't want. I'm going to get on the outside of this corner until I have the rotation tool, and I'm going to hold Shift and snap it to 45 degrees. I'll hit O to reflect, and then I'll hit Option or Alt to change the anchor point to right about here. And that'll bring up the dialog box, and we'll do a vertical copy. So now we have two of these that are lined up in the middle. I'm going to come over here to Pathfinder and choose the Unite Shape mode. I'll zoom in and see what's happened. Okay, they're not overlapping, and with Pathfinder, they have to be overlapping for those tools to work. So I'm going to click on this one and hold Shift and just bring it over a little bit. Select both and then try again. Okay, and this looks nice. I'm going to Command minus or Control minus on a PC to zoom out. All right, I'm going to give this a different fill. So I'm going to double click my white fill and make it just kind of a dark gray. We'll say okay. I'll click on my outline and get rid of that. Now I'm going to Command minus or Control minus to zoom out. And then I'm going to hold Shift and Option, Shift and Alt on a PC to make a copy down here. And I'm going to make this one a little bit bigger. So I'll hit S on my keyboard to get to my scale tool and then hit Enter or Return. I think I want this one to be about maybe 130% of what it is now. Let's preview. I think I want it a little bit bigger. We'll put it at 150. That looks nice. So I'll say, okay, let's get on our blend tool. I'll double click that. And I'm going to choose maybe 10 steps between those two. And all that does is change the setting. It doesn't actually make the blend yet. So I'm going to click on the first piece and then click on the second piece. And now you can see that it's added 10 shapes between. I don't actually want that many though, so let's undo, and I'm going to change that to 6. I'm going to select both and hit Option Command B or Alt Control B on a PC is another way to do it. All right, this looks a little better. I don't like how it spaced them out though, so I'm going to come up here to Object Expand, and we'll do the Object and Fill. Make sure that Align to Selection is chosen. We'll have to ungroup, so Shift Command G or Shift Control G, and then we'll distribute spacing. Okay, this looks pretty nice. I'm gonna highlight it, and then I'm gonna create a brush from it. So to do that, I'll click and drag into my brushes palette. Now, if you don't see your brushes or colors or anything over here, those are all up under Window. All right, let's choose Art Brush, and we'll say okay. Now with the art brush, we want to scale proportionally, and we'll also choose tints here. That way you can easily recolor it. We'll say, okay. Now let's make a circle. So I'll hit L on my keyboard and draw a circle. I'm holding Shift to constrain it proportionally. I'm going to hit A to get my direct selection tool and delete this point, which will leave me with half a circle. And now I'll use that art brush on that half. Let's get rid of our fill. You can see we have a pretty nice little half laurel, but I think I want more of these. So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of these middle ones and go ahead and do another blend. So we'll make this one 10 steps. I'll click on the first piece and then the last piece. And this looks much better. I'm gonna expand this real quick. I'll just kind of go through all of the steps so that we can get to this point. All right. I'm going to take these shapes, click and drag and hold Option or Alt and just replace this art brush over here in my brushes. And this is all looking fine. And I'll say, okay, I want to apply to strokes. And now this is looking much nicer. It just looks better with some more laurels in it. So I'm going to hit O on my keyboard Then hit Option or Alt to set a new anchor point. We'll choose vertical and we'll make a copy. All right, and I'll just move this one a little closer over here. And now I'm going to recolor it by just hitting I on my keyboard, holding Shift, and clicking on this color. Okay, so let's do another way of making a laurel. I'm going to copy this piece by holding Option or Alt, and then I'm going to make another copy holding Shift, Option, or Alt. And then I'll hit Command D or Control D to make a lot of them. I'm going to move these out of the way. And then I'll make this a little bit smaller. Okay, now we can turn this on its side and group it with Command G or Control G, and then go to Effect, Warp, and Arc. We can bend it quite a lot. It just warps it in a slightly different way. We'll say okay. And then I'm going to expand this with Shift Command E. I'm going to resize a little bit. And then I'll rotate with R. I'll hold Shift and it'll snap to the point that we want. And then I'll reflect it on the other side. So we'll hit O and then hold Option or Alt. And we want a vertical one and we'll copy. And you can see the difference between these two different types of laurels. There are actually more ways to make laurels, but we're not going to cover those in this video. Now I think I want to add a little logo seal thingy up here. I'll go get one. I got this one from Vecteezy. Now, if you want to use stuff off of Vecteezy, that's fine, but just know that they have rules about how you can use them. But of course, it's always okay to practice with them. So I'm copying that, and now I'll just paste here in my document. I'm going to make sure it's grouped by hitting Command G or Control G, and then I'll resize. And next, I think we need a date. So I'm going to select this piece right here. I'll copy that and paste in front, and then I'll just move that up. I'll switch the fill and stroke so I can see where it is. And then I'm going to do type along a path. So I'll choose it right under here. Whenever we do type on a path, it wants to sometimes put it underneath. Let's zoom in. So you'll want to pull this handle all the way over to the side and then take the middle piece and bring it up to the top. And we'll type out established 2020. I'll select everything, and then I'll come over here to my character palette. I'm going to choose Montserrat, which is one of my favorite fonts. We'll increase the size of this. So I'll hold Shift, Command, and the period key or the little caret, whatever you want to call that, and increase it a little bit. Then I'll hold Shift, Command, C, that's Shift, Control, C, and also Shift, Control, period, or caret. All right, I'll get back on my selection tool. Then I'll hit I on my keyboard. And I'll choose the gray color. And now we have a completed laurel. We can also add these same things to our other laurel if we wanted to. Make them a little smaller and move the whole thing over. So now you've got a little seal logo that you can use in all your graphics. All right, if you like my style of teaching, I have a few classes out on Skillshare. And if you're a member of Skillshare, you'll get access to those for free. And if you're not a member of Skillshare, I have a 2 free weeks free trial. And the link for that is in my description below. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.